getting ready to shift gears because I'll give you a little sneak peek. The next time I talk about a critical spirit, now Job's starting to get one. That's bad when you hit so hard that eventually it wears off on you. But tonight we're going to talk about one of the greatest ways to get to fight a critical spirit. I did this in the seniors a couple of weeks ago, but we're going to do it now. I was actually ready to do the Job, but this afternoon the Lord just spoke to me, and I believe this is for us. Come here, Brother Eddie. You pass out one, I'll pass out the other. How about that? There goes one, everybody. And we're all going to take turns today. Brother Eddie, when you get through, if you can grab that microphone, because it's not going to, we're all kind of, not a whole bunch of us, so we can get through. Just three. Pass, take one down, pass it around. And there's some for the back for you. Can you go back that way? And for John and all them. And the remnant, you stick on the back table. All right. One of the greatest ways to get over a critical spirit is to live a life of thanksgiving. We talked about thanksgiving on Sunday and about how thanksgiving actually gets God's attention. Going to church does not get God's attention. Going to church gets Satan's attention. And you can hear it. That's awesome. But going to church gets Satan's attention, and he'll do his best to keep you from getting God's attention. So if you're going to get God's attention, it's more than just going. You're going to have to do. You're going to have to be thanksgiving and praise. And so here we go. I've got this thing here, too. We're going to talk to everybody, give everybody a chance to talk tonight. I want you to write down on this list three things that you can be thankful for, and do it in each one in three words or less. Don't write a whole paragraph, just three words or less. One, two, three words or less. Write down what you're thankful for. And I'm going to come by and let you say it. And again, we don't have to go through a long give out speech. All we have to do is just say what I'm thankful for. And that's going to be cool. But let me just tell you a few things. Sunday, and let's go change my mind, because I'm more planning on doing this tonight. So I can say the Lord already changed my mind tonight. But Psalm 23 is definitely one of my favorite psalms. And Sunday morning coming up, we're going to be talking about going through the dark valleys in life. And I know we all have some dark valleys, every last one of us. Well, Psalm 23 says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in the green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. But thou art with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." What we need, buddy? Oh, you're getting microphones.
I'm lazy.
Okay, I was making sure I weren't sitting on whatever you were needing. No, or had it by my feet.
If I put a microphone everywhere, then...
Okay, there you go. That'll work. I got a good example of this. Today, this morning, when Linda was getting ready to leave for work, I walked out and I put her coffee in the car and her breakfast because she was eating on the way. And I climbed in the car, and she says, "Well, I'd love to take you to work with me." And I said, "Well, I can't go this morning." And as I go back in the house, when I go back in the house, I notice that she's left her phone. And she didn't know she left her phone. And she needs her phone to work. For work. And so I just threw on my sandals or flip-flops and jumped in the car and tried to catch her. And she had about a 10-minute head start on me, I think. Maybe 5 minutes. And so I finally caught her in Greenville, and she was making the last turn off of 264 to go turn down by a 10. And so she sees me at the stoplight, and I'm waving, and she waves, and she goes, Ah, my phone. I couldn't even call her till I'm coming. So what I did was I called her office and said, if you get here before I get here, come back out. I got your phone. And so I told her I was getting ready to leave. I said, the Lord said, I even told us today's going to be a great day for you. You know, God's blessing you. And when I left, I said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. And that word follow means chase you down. I said, surely goodness and mercy have chased you down today. You know, I brought your phone to you. Your blessings have chased you down. She said, which one are you, goodness, mercy, or surely? And I said, sometimes I'm one, sometimes I'm two, and sometimes I'm all three. Okay. Yes, she keeps on my toes. Being married to an Italian, you know, they don't play. I mean, they do play. They play a lot, but when they don't play, when they're not playing, they ain't playing. And they're from Virginia. She's from Virginia, too. And so, Brother Wayne's from Virginia. Y'all know about those Virginians. Okay. Yeah, I told somebody, I said, I wanted to have children after Linda and I got married. And Linda says, it'll be the shortest wedding and the shortest marriage in the world. She said, we're not going to have any more children. We got enough. But I said, can you imagine an Italian and a redneck? I said, instead of saying, I'm going to make you an offer, you can't refuse. He'll say, I'm going to make y'all an offer. You can't refuse. All right. So I'm thankful for Psalm 23. I'm thankful for God. I just a few things, points from here, and I'm going to tell you my three things. And then when everybody else take turns, tell them their three things. But again, Psalm 23, I like it. Just take it verse by verse. Not going to be quick. I mean, I'm not going to be drawn out. Just going to say a few words for each one. The Lord, the self-existent one, the one that needs nobody to prop him up, the one that's never sounded a retreat, the one that has never tried to had a time where he couldn't figure it out. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. So number one, I'm thankful because he provides. He said, I will provide. You shall not want. I'll take care of all your needs. He didn't say get out your seer's wish book. But he said, I'll take care of your needs. All right. Number two, he says, he makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He gives rest. Sheep will not rest when there's a lot of current flowing in the waters. It scares them. They will not drink water. They will not lay down. So the shepherd has to build a little dam up. And when he builds a little dam, it stops the water from running. And then the sheep, when once the water's still, they'll lay down in the green pastures and they're fine. And plus green pastures also, a lot of stuff would kill sheep. So he had to know what they could eat. So again, he not only provides, but he gives us rest. Verse 3, he restores my soul. He renews me. He restores me. There's a plane coming in somewhere. Okay.
It's the water. It's not been
steady. It's the water. Then he leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. He confidently leads me. He guides me. He directs me. And because of that, I know that I can be safe. And then also, in verse 4, he also protects me. Because, yea, thou walk through the valley of the shadow of death, thou will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they cover me. And I'm going to leave that alone, because that's where I'm going Sunday morning. So I'm going to leave that one right there, that he protects me. He also corrects me, and he comforts me. And so I thank him for that. Then, verse 5, you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. A little boy was having a hard time with his mama and his daddy one day, and they said, before you can eat, you're going to have to say a scripture verse, and you're going to have to say a blessing. And he said, I want to. And I said, boy, if you don't, I'm going to tear your britches up. He said, I don't feel like it. And he was really mad at his parents. So finally, he said, you got to come with the Bible verse, you got to pray. He said, all right, then, Lord, I thank you that you're preparing a table for me in the midst of my enemies. Didn't gain the beat. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. He's a partner with us. He partners with us. He's there with us. He goes through everything with us. He prepares us. It's our praise. He anoints our head with oil. Also, the sheep would get a lot of parasites on them. When a parasite was nagging them, they could not be still. They could not. It's like getting a mosquito in the bedroom at night. You know, and so they would have to fix them by putting oil on their face, and that would keep them from getting these parasites. And the whole idea of the shepherd was to feed them so they could reproduce and bring more sheep. And so that's what God does for us. He wants us to bring more people in. And then he's our praise, and then he's our paradise, for he says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So I'm thankful to God for all he's done. There's this little piece of paper you got that says, well, I'm thankful to God, three words or less. Again, one of the great, if you feel a critical spirit come on, and we can all do that. Has anybody in here ever felt a critical spirit coming on? Oh, yeah. When you feel a critical spirit coming on, when you feel like you're getting ready to let somebody have it, when you feel like you're getting ready to pull a Job's comfort, even pull a Job on them, you got to do this. 1 Thessalonians 5:18 says, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Didn't say that give thanks, or didn't say that it was the will of God for everything that happens to you. To be thankful that it's happening, but be thankful to God. Don't necessarily be thankful for the things, but be thankful to God. And everything give thanks to God. But that's the will of God in Christ concerning you, that you thank Him. Good, bad, or ugly, you thank Him. I want you to put this in on your refrigerator or somewhere, and when you get up in the morning, I want you to look at it, and I want you to thank God for these three things. I'm going to start it off. Number one, I am thankful for my shepherd. My shepherd, he provides life. He even gave his life for me. He's a good shepherd. He brings guidance and protection, and he helps me in my everyday life to be productive. So I thank God, my shepherd. Number two, I'm thankful for my wife and my family. You know, on Thanksgiving morning, one of the greatest presents I could have ever got was DC. I wrote to all the kids, I'm thankful for all y'all. And DC wrote back and said, I'm thankful to have a dad like you. And that was just awesome. You know, if he'd have been a little bitty fella, I'd have carried him right to Toys R Us. But I can't carry him to Toys R Us now because his Toys R Us are a whole lot bigger. Yes. And definitely thankful for my wife. She is awesome, and God uses her in so many ways to bring comfort and relief to a lot of people, and she's there for me, and I thank her for it. And number three, I'm thankful for my church family, because this is an awesome family, I can't think of any better family that I've ever had a part in than this. So there it is, my shepherd, my wife and family, and then my church family. Now, we'll start over at this end. Okay, you got a microphone? Give us three things you're thankful for. You saw.
I am kind of selfish. I particularly want to thank the Lord for my implant.
That's awesome.
Because it is working.
Amen.
And number two, I thank the Lord for my husband.
Amen.
That goes with me and works with me to help this come about.
Amen.
Amen. I'm thankful for our pastor.
Amen. Amen.
I don't know what we do without
him. Vice versa. Same way. Amen.
I'm thankful that God gave me salvation.
Amen.
And I'm particularly thankful for all of the church family here.
Yes.
They've been so wonderful all the years we've been together. And the new ones coming in also, Lord.
Amen.
And a special blessing, Lord, upon the community that we're in.
Yes.
Help us to win it for you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. I've got a mic over this way today.
Yep. All you got to do is pick it up.
Okay. Yeah. She passed the buck quick.
Matt Clinton was going to go slow here third, I reckon. So.
Okay, here you go.
I'm thankful for my salvation, like Brother Billy said, the fact that Jesus Christ died for me. You know, he might not die for y'all, but he died for me.
That's right.
Also, I'm thankful for my family, my loving wife, for supporting me. I know I just run front of hospital runs, and sometimes you don't like to do it by ourselves, save ourselves, but she's never complained about me going off doing that. And then my third thing, I'm thankful for my relationship with God.
Amen.
He knows how I am. He knows I'm half nuts. He likes me like that. He doesn't want to change.
Wayne and I wrote the same thing almost. Not really.
Almost, but not really, okay.
I'm thankful for my salvation.
Yes.
My salvation.
That's right.
Not just salvation, but mine.
That's right.
And the blessings that we have that are undeserved.
That's right.
Because we don't deserve any of them, really.
That's right.
My awesome family and our health to be able to do things.
Yes.
I really wouldn't just... And then our last one's my wonderful friends.
Amen. Amen. Okay, now you got it. hold on, baby. Turn, get that one, that was not on.
You need two on that.
So I thank God for my
good health. Amen.
And I thank Him for being my Savior.
Amen.
And then I thank
Him
for my son for healing.
Amen.
And I thank
Him
for his
father that He died for each one of us. That's awesome. That's awesome. See, when you hear stuff like this, how can you not fight a critical spirit when you get hearing this stuff? Your turn.
My turn. First of all, I'm thankful for Christ.
Amen.
He provided salvation.
Yes.
Because He's the Son of God.
Yes.
He was given to us. And in turn, I'm thankful for the Word of God, which Father God presented to us through the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
He's Son referred to. And I'm thankful that God uses His Spirit that indwells in us, and that we're not ourselves. We were bought with a price, and we belong to God. And we have a 24-hour-a-day relationship.
That's right.
Through the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And second, I'm thankful for my family, not just my blood family, but also my royal blood family.
That's right.
The church family.
That's right.
And through the years, I've got to know you, and you've got to know me, and have prayed through me and for me in tremendous times of dire need. You have brought me through many, many hard times. And third, I'm thankful for individual friendships that have developed among you in times that we've spent together and
yes.
Continue to spend together and just plain holy laughter that we share
yes.
Because God loves laughter.
Yes, He does.
And not mockery, but plain old good fellowship and laughter.
That's
and
right.
I'm thankful for this.
If He didn't love laughter, you know what? All the kids loved Him. All the kids loved Jesus. And if they loved Jesus, He had to be laughing. You know, I almost got in trouble the other night because Annalene was getting in trouble with her mom and daddy. And while they were getting in trouble when she was getting in trouble with her mom and daddy, they said, you need to sit down. And she said, So my pawpaw told me I could do anything I wanted to. And I did not tell her that. She might have heard that, but that's not what I told her. So
I can react.
Yeah, definitely the actions, yeah. Okay, go ahead.
Sometimes we have to let them go, but I still want to know a lot about
trust. We have a Father in heaven that will never let us down. And you know, I think that that's what he's doing this day and time, is that he's wanting us to know that we got to learn to trust him first.
That's right. That's right.
Now we can have our friends. We can have a pastor. But these people are human.
Oh, yeah.
And so, as I am a widow, I have lived alone. I had only him. And so, when there's nobody else that you can trust, you can't always put your faith in people. Because I've tried that. And sometimes you can get hurt bad. Because people are human.
And we're human. Praise God, God's there.
And he's always there.
Always there. Always.
And he'll never hurt you.
No.
He'll never let you down. So we gotta live. I have to live here in this world. But I know that he will always be with me, like he was, and he has always been for me. So I gotta learn to put a smile on my face and hold my head up.
That's right.
And know what I got.
That's right.
The best of all.
That's right. Yes, you do. Here you go. Right here, sister.
Yes, too.
They got one down there.
Oh, they got one.
I'm going to get both of y'all's friends. I'm going to confiscate both of them. Who's the other one in? That daughter. All right. Okay. All right.
I'm thankful for God's love, for my family, for my church family, which includes my awesome pastor, and my job that I love to do probably 99% of the time. It's a really, really, really good percentage. I think, I don't know, I just took it differently, but not really. I kind of was very broad, but I also was thinking about, I'm thankful for all those things that everybody mentioned, but I was really thinking about the things specifically in my life right now that I'm extremely thankful for learning to, as Pastor said Sunday, during that life of thanks living. So my first thing, I said life, and that includes eternal life, and that includes my health and getting up and be able to go to work and do my job and come to church and the things that I get to do is all the aspects of life. From now all the way through eternity when I get to see Jesus. My second one is my family. That includes my church family and my friends that are close to me like family, because I wouldn't be where I am without them. And the last one is the one the guys just been dealing with me recently about having peace and having joy, no yes. matter what the circumstances
That's
is.
Right.
Just finding that joy
That's
and
right.
having a positive outlook on things, because then when you have that joy and you have that mindset of you're gonna, our expression was, make it a great day or not, the choice is yours. Is that when you choose to have that positive attitude, the peace comes with it. There are
That's
lots
right.
of days where I get up and I don't, you know, I don't want to think about what's going to happen, all the things that could go wrong, but when I think about it and know that God's got it under control, then I can still have peace.
That's right. Y'all doing some good stuff, man. It's all good. All of it's good.
I'm thankful for my salvation, for my family, and for my country, and I pray that when we have new elections, we'll get new Christian leaders for our country.
Amen.
Yeah.
A By the way, who was it that just read it good and they could even speak about it? The politically incorrect sheriff's office. Can somebody say that for us? I love it. We're not politically correct. We thank God. We praise God. We salute our troops. We say, I mean, it's awesome.
Say Merry Christmas.
Say Merry Christmas. God it's so America, awesome. It is. God bless America. Oh, man. Every time I see it, it gets me excited. I mean, it's just awesome.
I'm thankful for God's mercy. I'm thankful for my family.
Yes.
And I'm thankful for all my good Christian friends.
Amen. Awesome.
Everybody's on the video when you were talking.
You're like a news reporter.
Yeah, news reporter. You got to get the camera just right. I only put three words on mine, one on each line. Jesus, family, and life.
Awesome.
And I can't say anything more about it because everybody else has said it for me.
It all said it. Amen. Also, you got these scriptures on Thanksgiving. These scriptures right here. Put this around somewhere so when you're feeling the mully grubs or you're feeling the critical spirit come on or you're feeling something or you've just been hit with it. Before Christmas, please. But look, y'all, look at these scriptures. Look at these scriptures. I thought she was going to say something. Look at these scriptures. Read these scriptures. Put this on the refrigerator. Put it up on the wall somewhere. Put it by your bed. Put it in your Bible. And inside your Bible, inside your Bible, you will be able to look at this. Maybe this is a battery. What's that? Check. Is the battery dead?
No, it's not dead, but I'll try another one.
Okay. Put things in your Bible because it's amazing. Because I remember when my wife was dying and I was doing a wedding down at the Elizabethan Gardens. And I was in the Elizabethan Gardens by myself for a couple hours. I was praying and I had to pick out a leaf and I was holding that leaf and the Lord spoke to me and said, "You're going to be in this garden. Pledging your undying love, and your wife's been pledging her love back to you." And I said, "How can that happen?" But I took it and stuck it in my Bible. She died. And then I didn't even think about it when I got married. Again, God sent me Linda. We were at Elizabethan Gardens. And she said, "I love you so much." And I said, "I love you so much, love my Bible." And out fell that. The little thing that I had kept was a promise from God. So God's promises don't always make sense when you get them, when they're given to you, but they're really awesome when they come to pass. Amen. That's right. Anybody else got anything they want to say? All right. Oh, go ahead.
I just wanted to let everybody know that be spreading the word about our parade here at Edward on the 20th. It's, Rhonda told me today it's looking like we've got over 40 entries at this point, and they're still coming in.
And we may get a chance to get the Piggly Weekly Pig. If we do, I hope to put a blanket on him.
That one took me a second when he told me.
Let's pray. Father, I love you. You're an awesome God. You're a powerful God. We know, Lord, we can trust you totally. We know, God, that you got everything under control. We know, God, that no matter what's coming our way, you've got this. I thank you for touching. I thank you for anointing. I thank you, God, for ministering. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for it all. We praise your name. The church said,
Amen.
Amen. All right. Check. Is that working good? I'll leave that one up there then. All right.